When you think of the word metal, what image springs to mind? For many, it's a hard, gleaming object, perhaps a shining sword, a sleek automobile, or a polished piece of silverware. In our day-to-day lives, we primarily interact with metals in their solid state. But is that the only form that they can take? Could a metal also exist as a gas? The surprising answer is yes, provided the right temperature and pressure conditions are met. The states of matter are universally applicable, which means that metals can become solid, liquid, or gas. For instance, take lead, which naturally exists in a solid state, but has a boiling point of 1740 degrees Celsius. When heated to 327 degrees Celsius, solid lead transforms into a liquid. When heated further, the liquid vaporizes into a gas at its boiling point. Mercury offers another fascinating example. With the lowest boiling point of all metals, a mere 356.7 degrees Celsius, mercury transitions from its liquid state to a gaseous one at a relatively low temperature. However, despite its interesting properties, mercury vapors pose serious health risks, as stated by the World Health Organization. If inhaled, they can inflict severe damage to the nervous, digestive, and immune systems, as well as the lungs and kidneys. Moreover, the inorganic salts of mercury can harm the skin, eyes, and gastrointestinal tract, possibly resulting in kidney toxicity if ingested. Turning to another facet of this exploration into the gaseous forms of metal, is a metal in its gaseous state still considered a metal? Unfortunately, the properties that characterize a metal, metallic bonds, conductivity, ductility, and luster, are not retained when a metal transforms into a gas. Therefore, gaseous metals, though still defined as the same chemical element, can no longer be considered metals. They are more accurately described as a gas with certain distinctive properties inherited from their parent element, for example, mercury gas. Understanding atomic structures helps to explain why metals exist as solids at room temperature. All matter comprises atoms, and the proximity of these atoms to each other determines the state of a substance. Gas molecules tend to move freely, far apart from each other. The molecules in a liquid, though still somewhat mobile, are closer together, while the atoms in a solid are densely packed in crystalline structures. This tight packing generates powerful forces, causing solids to be rigid and maintain their set shape and size, characteristics that are absent in gases and liquids. Metals in their solid form have a fixed or set structure due to their atoms' close packing, which also contributes to their high melting points and explains why they don't exist in a liquid state at room temperature. Consequently, though metals can indeed transform into gases when heated to their boiling points, they lose their metallic properties upon doing so.